whether the Ember needs to get the Manta Star or not.
Right, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Getting ourselves in. IG versus Cloud9 here. The MarsTV Dota 2 League. This is, of course, the quarterfinals. I'll warn you guys, spoilers. So close your ears. I'm going to tell you what happened in the other quarterfinals. If you want to watch the VODs, don't listen. So the winner of the other quarterfinals was indeed Empire. So the other finals is going to be Empire versus Vici Gaming. That's going to be the semifinals that will be tomorrow. And the second semifinals will, of course, be Secret versus the winner of this game. So we're going to have two very exciting games tomorrow, and well, one exciting game right now here, the deciding one of this series. And I mean, looking at the drafts opening up, Winter, is there anyone that you kind of feel has the more stable draft this match?
I think IG's lineup has less room for error, and C9's lineup has more room for error in a game like this, because they have a better matchup in the late game and a lot of map control with the Frozen Sigil and the Night Stalker Vision. So I would say C9's lineup has more room. They can afford to make mistakes, but IG has to be more on point with their ganks, with the Clockwork and the Shaker.
And lane-wise, it looks for the time being that it is going to be this tri-lane safe lane, and of course the solo lane Luo. At least that's what their IG is sending themselves out to do, which will almost certainly mean that Bone7 will be left alone on the offlane. And it's going to be, do you feel it's going to be a hard level for this Tusk to find a lot from the offlane?
He should be able to get some levels early, I think, because it's an Earthshaker. Earthshaker, it's a melee hero and an Ember. There's two melee heroes in the lane. And yeah, here we go, the first rune, they're going to have a huge fight over here, but that's Earthshaker, so C9 has to be very careful with that rune.
They do indeed. We're going to see the Void being thrown out onto Burning. Burning is just going to stand his ground and he will look to take it. Aisha, oh, Bo7!
Damn! That was
damn good. That was... that was perfectly done.
That was really, really good. It was just in the perfect position where he blocked them off and he was the only one who could have access to that bounty rune. That was a big, big eye shot.
Yeah, it was very nice. And at the same time, worth noting, he was able to claim the bottom bounty rune for himself as well.
Yeah.
So, good
Luo
start for C9.
Luo even took battery assault to actually try to snatch the rune, and he didn't. So, not having the Korks would mean he would have a harder level 1 in the lane.
Indeed. Well, we'll see how much the Clockwork's able to achieve here. We've got Big Daddy already laying down the aggression here onto Chuan. Fisher will come out. It's going to be Big Daddy has to take the longer route round, but he's going to be fine. Yeah, good old Night Stalker on 587 HP, 5 armor straight out of the can. And, they're still going to try and chase down Big Daddy. He's trying to do what he can. There's going to be a second Fisher, and hey, he might be in a bit of trouble here. He's getting low. He's a little bit trapped out. He's going to try and walk around. He steals himself a cheeky CS on the way out. Dukes out the Illuminate. It's not enough, and he will go down. And that is going to give first blood there to Chuan. So Big Daddy maybe going a little bit too AWOL there on the top lane.
Yeah, he was trying really hard to steal the neutrals and get some experience there, but it worked against him. He was a little too greedy there, and he paid the price for it. But looking at the other lanes as well, like Feta started off with a Clarity. It's not often you see Queen of Pain starting with Clarity, but probably means that he wants to spam the Shadow Strike a lot more than usual.
I mean, at the moment, pretty even in the mid lane, 6-2, 6-2. Big Daddy returns to the top lane. We did see on the bottom lane Luo trying to see if he could go aggressive into the jungle, trying to catch out Misery. And Misery doing what he can, creating the space for EE. And EE on this PL, I mean, you're talking about the fact that he needs to have a good 10 minutes. We're a couple of minutes in so far to this game, and he seems to be having a fine old time against this Clockwork.
Yeah, it's still really looking really good from C9, even after the first bird. I mean, things still looking good for the Phantom Lancer like you mentioned, and well, C9 is going to get a really good rune. It's going to have an Invis rune on the line, and this would be a rune that's going to pressure the Shadow Fiend a lot, even though they saw the rune there. This is going to be a lot of pressure on the Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, ping is coming out there from Luo onto the Ferrari 430 SF, just making sure he backs up and keeps himself safe. And he certainly will, just getting himself bottled up and getting that cycled back. And I don't think Misery's going to be able to find anything here. And Chuan is actually rotating in as well, maybe looking to counteract any kind of action that this invisible line might look to go for. But yeah, Lion's just going to head back to bot.
But so far, the Clockwork has more last hits than the Shadow Fiend in the lane. Oh dear, that is not good for the Shadow Fiend.
And that's certainly true, yeah. We saw it being fairly even, but yeah, after that bit of pressure, causing Ferrari to back up. Of course, found a lot of space and time, and Fada's going to be very happy with this. Chuan is hanging around in the mid lane, just getting ready to see if the Queen of Pain overextends, but Vata keeping himself sensible at the moment and just looking to farm up safely from his own side of the river.
Yeah, they need to focus on getting stacks for the Shadow Fiend, because the Shadow Fiend definitely needs it this game. He's being under a lot of pressure from the Queen of Pain. And the Lion obviously getting the Invis rune that has a huge impact on the laning phase of the Shadow Fiend.
And dealing with these pulls as well, Mizru going to be able to find himself a fair bit of XP. If we look at the supports of the side of IG, they're still doing pretty well. Level 3 at the moment on Faith. Chuan with this rotation, still just sitting at level 2 and still just kind of babysitting the Shadow Fiend. And now we're going to see a smoke up from Cloud9. Both Bone 7 and Big Daddy rotating towards the mid lane. Chuan is going to look for the rune. And oh, there's your snowballing straight away onto the Earthshaker. Blink 4 from Fartu is going to join in for the fun as well. And that will be a kill there, taking down Chuan. As well, a very nice rotation there from the side of Cloud9 for this top lane, just catching IG totally off guard.
And the first night phase is about to kick in, and that was a really key kill for them to have. Nice stock there, level 3 now, and it's gonna be quite a threat in the first night phase, I feel. The Shadow Fiend is gonna be under a lot of pressure. He can't really walk into the jungle when the night stalker's not around, so he's not gonna be able to get his jungle stack up, and he's gonna be needing the Earthshaker to have 24/7 protection on him at all times during this night phase.
Chuan's heading towards the mid lane. There also was Luo hanging around here as well. He's had to, well, he backed off for the rune, and now he's just back in return to returning to lane. But EE has just found a lot of space and time here. Worth noting though as well, over on the side of IG, Burning, he's finding an equal amount of farm to this PL. You know, the Tusk and Night Stalker combo wasn't really able to do that much in terms of disrupting his farm, and he's still looking incredibly healthy at this point, 5 minutes into the game for the side of IG.
Yeah, but the Shadow Fiend is just under a lot of pressure, so the Ember would be needing to help out the team later on, compared to the PL. PL can afford to farm more, but Ember has to help his team out. And Boa's gonna try and trap Misery in his cogs with the level 2 battery assault.
And we're also going to see in the mid lane a bit of action here. It's both 7 snowball in front of Ferrari. Ice Shard's going to force Faith and Chuan back. And it looks like they're just going to end up trapping each other out. No one's going to find anyone. And indeed, as you said, Luo was just trying to rest down Misery. No one dying at the moment, though. And towards the mid and towards the bottom. And oh, hello. Looking for a cheeky courier. Nah, he's not nearly enough damage for that. The courier is going to be able to safety get the bottle down to EE. And I mean, this is the classic kind of EE thing to do. We see a lot of kind of position ones liking to do this nowadays, getting a bottle on their core. And in a lane situation like this, it's, I guess, it's the most sensible thing to do in terms of keeping yourself topped up, and just means that you're never really going to be that vulnerable to potential roamings and ganks from the side of IG.
Yeah, PR is a hero that can help early. So if you get a good rune, like a haste rune or any like a DD rune, you'll be able to contribute a lot with the bottle charge. So it's definitely a very useful item for carry to have early game.
Well, he's going to be able to bottle himself up an invis. Won't be looking to use it for the time being. Just returning into lane, getting the lances out onto Luo top lane. Burning, trying to put on the pressure here to this tier 1. He's got himself the phase boots, level 6 as well. But at the same, just looking at the draft of C9, I mean, even without the Orchid pickup coming anytime soon on the Queen, the fact you've got a Lion and a Night Stalker, Burning's got to be very, very careful about potentially being caught out, especially at nighttime.
Yeah, they have a lot of tools to deal with him for sure. And if he wants to deal with the Orchid, like I mentioned before, he can go for the first item Manta, but it depends on how quick the Queen of Pain is going to get the Orchid. And so far, because of the Earthshaker babysitting the Shadow Fiend, he's been able to get back on par with the CS of the Queen of Pain.
Oh, look at this on the bottom lane. Big Daddy looking for the potential wraparound here onto Luo. Luo, if he comes anything a little closer, well, that's enough here with the Lars. They're going to go in with the Void and the Crippling Fear. They're ready to try and take down this clock. He's fairly tanky, not tanky enough, though. They will find a kill. There'll be a TP reaction coming in. It's actually going to be cancelled straight away from the Shadow Fiend, leaving Burning on his own down here. And maybe Cloud9 could look to go for more here. Burning, has he got a remnant out somewhere across the map?
No.
He's going to be okay, though. I was going to say he needs to be backing himself up there, because the side of Cloud9, they're ready to go for round two then.
He's gonna collect his bottle, so that's gonna heal him up a bit, and maybe they're gonna leave the safe lane for the clock now. No, he still needs a little bit of experience before he gets his level 6. Yeah, he's gonna go up top and rotate the carry down to the more difficult lane.
Okay, I mean, I guess this makes, at this point, Burning should be able to put a bit of pressure onto EE as he tries to farm. Do you think this is the best move for IG?
Yeah, definitely, because the PL is not going to be comfortable laning against an Ember with level 7 and max Flame Guard. This is going to be a bit of pressure on him, and at the same time, they're going to be able to get farm on the Ember in this lane, and Clockwork will be able to farm on the top lane.
Oh, Big Daddy, he was trying to move in close and personal here with the smoke. Won't be able to get any jump onto Tron. Bone 7 still under the cover of it. Ferrari might head up into the jungle here. Is this the best thing to do? I don't know, because Big Daddy's going to come in blink for him faster with a sonic wave onto Tron. Try getting incredibly over Tron. He's going to be able to turn around and get a Fisher. And now the side of IG, they want to try and turn around. Burning will find one. Can he find a second one? Remnanting 40 will. He'll find Bone 7 as well. And even though IG kind of walked up into the high ground, it worked out at the end of the day because, well, they might find more here. They certainly will. They've got hook shot. I think Big Daddy's going to go down as well. Yeah, it's going to be a double kill for Ferrari 430. And Cloud9, they just throw it all away there in the dire jungle. What was going on there, Winter?
The Sonic Wave hit the Shadow Fiend and the Scream of Pain. I mean, the Sonic Wave hit the Earthshaker but not the Shadow Fiend. And the Scream of Pain hit the Shadow Fiend but not the Earthshaker. So he didn't land both the spells on two heroes. They both only hit one target, that's why they couldn't even kill one hero there. So that was the main reason why they lost that small fight there.
Yeah, it wasn't too great for them at all. Like, just the same time there for Cloud9, you know, he's managed to stick himself here on the bottom lane. He continues to farm up. I mean, in terms of PL builds, what do you think we can expect to see from him in this game? Is this a game where you pick up a Vlad and you just look to farm up in your jungle, or is he going to look to fight?
I think Vlad's would be a good pickup here, because if you look at Cloud9's lineup, they don't have a hero that utilizes the jungle a lot. So the PL can go for a build where that allows him to jungle very, very quickly. So the Vlad's is definitely a good option here for the Phantom Lancer before he builds into any big damage item, like the Diffuser or the Yasha.
I mean, with the kind of the lineup that IG have got, do you think, I mean, is there any kind of pressure on them this game against this PL, or do you feel that no matter what the PL picks up, IG eventually will always be able to deal with it?
I think they have very good heroes to deal with. Amber with Shadow Fury, eventually Shadow Fiend, and Top Rune, Burning's gonna get picked off that finger.
Just enough burst damage as well, and the fact that, you know, he's got, what, the level 4 Flame Guard, even that wasn't enough to help him sustain against the amount of magical burst that the side of Cloud9 had. And that's a big kill there for Cloud9, being able to shut down Burning, who's been having a relatively good game so far in terms of farm.
Yeah, every time you have the finger up on a support line, you want to use it to get the biggest kill you can get. And in this game, it would be either the Shadow Fiend or the Ember, and he killed the Ember. So it was a really good first kill for the finger there.
I mean, the fact that, you know, Ferrari got that double kill, and that's helped him out a lot. You know, we saw him at the beginning suffering a little bit against the Farta Quad, but now at this point, coming up to 11 minutes, and he's top of the net worth with 5.1k gold in the bank.
Yeah, and he just purchased
Dire's
his mech.
Top tower is under attack.
Yeah, he just finished his mech. He's just back into this game after the rough start that he has, so that's a very good thing for IG. So they'll be able to use the mech to probably push on at least a couple of tier 1 towers in the next couple of minutes when the Night Stalker is still on daytime.
And let's see, has he bought anything yet? Nope, still coming up to 2k gold, yet to decide what he's purchasing. Still kind of checking out the lay of the land. Bone 7, how's he doing? He's level 7, 1k gold on top of the arcanes. Big Daddy no tell, he's still yet to hit 6. He's got the stick in the urn, and yeah, exactly as you said, Ferrari with the mech, IG grouping up in the mid lane. They're going to look to take some towers and potentially a fight if the clutch side of C9 want to react to this one.
Maybe he's thinking of getting a Yasha, or did he buy Boost of Travel? What did he buy? He bought something. Yeah, he bought Boost of Travel.
Okay.
The greediest. It's envy being the greedy build, so what's new?
Absolutely.
It has its merits because it's going to allow him to,
lucky that Hex was there. I was gonna say, he did get the boost of travel out to him. At least the Burning will only just be able to round away. Oh, the Sonic Wave! Oh, thank you for the pure damage, says Varta. And well, that's a way to kill an Ember Spirit. That was a big play there.
That was a much, much better Sonic Wave compared to the first one. Yeah, that was a key kill on the Ember once more. This Ember is not catching a break. Dying twice in a row, and the tier 1 still gonna go down for C9, I feel.
Maybe the side of IG can find some kills at the back of this here. Luo trying to move in close to Perso. He's got the hook shot available. There's going to be a Fisher thrown down, catching out E, trying to hold him back. And Luo, he's actually going to get blinked on here, and he's the one in trouble as Farta and Bone 7 are able to take him down. And that's going to be another kill.
Shadow Fiend didn't manage to get the last hit on the tower. That was huge.
Well,
5-4, Cloud9. Leading the way. I mean, let's have a look at the graph so far, how they developed 30 minutes in. Cloud9 off the back of that. They're reaching a little bit of a lead. It's only 2k and 1k. It's small steps. But again, I mean, we're looking at the series so far. We knew it was going to be a bit of a close clash. And so far, both teams meeting head on. And each fight kind of alternately going in favor of either sides. And side of IG, they're going to look to try and take this tier one here on the top lane. Big Daddy just skipping the creeps out, allowing the space and time for Misery and Farts to maybe put some pressure here on the tier one on the top lane. But TPing from Faith, he is all alone here on this top lane. We'll see what he's able to do.
He can recall one, and Clockwork's already nearby, so they want to take the bottom tier one and make sure they defend the top tier one as well. Radiant's
bottom tower has fallen. Oh, here we go. Nice play.
Nice Sucker wants to go in from the side here, but...
Oh, that finger! That was disgustingly long. And now we're going to see the rest of Cloud9 stand up for this fight. They've taken down Burning as well. It's two heroes down the side of IG. Can they find anything more? Bo7, he is trapped here in the Cox. He will be able to get a sigil out. And this might allow Cloud9 to clean up here. They're going to go into Tron. They'll bring down the Earthshaker. Can they find the way here as well? The Crumbling Fear has been laid down. He will find the slow with the last. The Void slow as well, getting close to Personal. He's going to try and TP out. It looks like Luo will get himself away. But it ends up being a 3-for-1 favoring the side of C9. And C9 as well looks to be able to take this tier 1 out. The fortification will be there, but what a fight there for Cloud9.
That was really weird though, because the Shadow Fiend teleported towards the middle when he's your most farm hero and he has the mech on your team, so if you're going to take a big fight like this, you need the Shadow Fiend to come.
Burning, he wants to fight into this one. There's going to be a blink away from Farta. Big Daddy just popping down the Crippling Fear, stopping him from going in, and well, this time it will be IG with the denies. Burning will be able to deny that tier 1 from the side of C9.
And the reason C9 was able to win that fight convincingly was because the Shadow Fiend was not there at all. That was the main reason why. That was really surprising. They defended without the Shadow Fiend.
And off the back of that, IG, they're going to want to look to kind of regain what they had, and they're trying to do it here with a tier 1 push. Cloud9, they'll pop out the fortification. Do they want to try and defend this? You've got Fada in the mid lane. He has got the Sonic Wave. He's also got a Haste Rune, which would be nice for this fight if they want to take it. Big Daddy on the front lines. Ice Shard's coming out, just trying to trap and hold IG in, but it looks like IG will be able to take this tier 1. Fada's just heading back to base. He's got himself an Ultimate Orb now. Is he going to TP out for this now? It's too late. Luo will be able to claim this tier 1 here. So off the back of a bad team fight, IG, they're able to find something. And also going to smoke up here and maybe look for some more action. Oh, Big Daddy. Just chilling out on the high ground in for a Void down onto Fave. Oh, the Sonic Wave blows up the console. Connects on the rest. The mech comes out from Ferrari. The question is, do they want to keep fighting into this one, Cloud9? Big Daddy's starting to run. There's going to be Snowball coming in onto Luo. They'll be able to punch Luo down. Burning turn up to the fight. We'll bring down Big Daddy. No set with the help of Ferrari. Ferrari looking for Rekker and Souls. We'll cancel it. Doesn't need it. Now E's turned up with a Lancer to Ferrari. Ferrari's just going to TP straight out. There's going to be an Ice Shards. Ferrari will be able to escape. Tron tries to TP as well. The stone comes through. It doesn't matter because already with the scream, they picked off the Lion. Now they're going to look for the Burning as well. Sorry, they're going to find it. Looks like Burning can't get himself out of this one. We'll run to the sidelines. There's a CP. Oh, does he escape? Does he escape? No, he doesn't. Double kill for Farta. And again, C9 taking some very strong fights against IG. 12-6.
That was one mostly because the Queen of Pain dealt so much damage with the Sonic Wave there on three heroes. That was a big, big Sonic Wave. And Shadow Fiend wasn't able to get off a good Requiem. And he was forced to TP out of the fight again very early on. So his teammates were just left to die after that. After the biggest hero on your team had to make his way out.
Oh, here we go. Nighttime's being popped. And C9, they want to find more here. They want to try and find Ferrari. They're going to give him a bit of a tickle here with a Void. There's going to be TPs coming into the tier 1. In the sidelines, you've got EE. He has got that Yasha indeed. And well, far outside of IG might want to fight into this one. They've got Luo here with the hookshot available. Burning's been brought in as well by Faith. And well, C9 is just keeping themselves out of it. Misery trying to find some farm in the top lane. He's got himself the Blink Dagger. And all in the jungle. There's going to be a bit of a rumble. Luo, he's got the hook shards. Does he want to try and pop it? He's going in. There's going to be the Ice Shards trapping out the clock while he pops out the cogs. The Crippling Fear as well. Luo's in a lot of trouble here. Bo7 telling us as well. There's going to be the Blinding Light there. Actually pushing it here onto the side of the clogs. And oh, in fact, the hook shot missing them all. Just a little short one onto Ferrari. Misery's looking for the stone. We'll be able to get it out onto Ferrari. But it looks like Lion will take out into the Flame Guard. It will do indeed. There's going to be a record of souls because Shadow Fiend's got down as a 1-for-1 trade so far. The question is, who could continue this fight? Blink out from Farta. IG, they're trying to continue this one. There's a Fisher onto 2.7. He's been going to Cape Town. He will just be able to get himself away. It's a 2-for-2 trade so far. Farta, he wants to continue. He's got a Sonic Wave here in 8 seconds. They might be able to find Burning. Burning Remnants again aggressively. He wants to find the kill onto this Tusk, but I don't know if he's going to find it. 0.7 with the Walrus Punch. They'll be able to bring that. The slight of Fish comes out just in time, allowing Burning to bring down the Bone 7 Tusk with him. But it is a double kill for EE. The trade ends 4-for-3, favoring the side of Cloud9. And, well, there's a lot of action this game, Winter, and it seems to be favoring Cloud9 for the most part of it.
Yeah, they didn't lose the PL, so that's a huge win for them. And both of the biggest core on IG died, the Shadow Fiend and the Ember. So, I mean, if you're IG, you're going to be very, very worried right now. The PL is getting out of control, and your Ember has basically not much of an item progression since the early game. That's about it.
Absolutely not. I mean, yeah, net worth wise, yeah. The fact that EE now sitting at the top of the board.
Oh, top lane. Chuan seems like, see you later.
See you later, indeed. Oh, wow. that BM finger there wasn't necessary, but it certainly felt good for Misery, and, well, didn't feel good for Chuan. Burning, remnanting forward. Maybe he can find a return kill. Oh, Misery with a little blink to the sidelines there. We'll be able to TP out. And the rest of IG coming in, but it's all too late, as Chuan is well and truly dead.
The Quap has a Hex, I think. Yeah, he has a Hex. That is going to be very troublesome for the Ember now.
19 minutes in. It's a little bit crazy. The amount of gold and such that C9 have found from this fight. So let's have a look at the graphs. 7.5k in terms of XP. Gold-wise, we're over 5k. The momentum is certainly there for Cloud9. Now, we saw them get a bit of momentum in the second game, and IG were able to turn it right round. The question is whether IG can do it again this game. It's certainly going to be a lot harder. EE will just TP out this one. Oh, that is a lovely hook shot there onto EE. Have they got the burst damage? Yes, they do. And that was a very nice calculated pickoff from IG, getting EE there on the retreat.
He didn't run away from the rocket threat vision. He was TPing under the vision. That's why they saw him there. That was a bit of just too greedy. He didn't run far enough before he started to TP, though he got hooked. Otherwise, I don't think he would have died there. And as a result of that, Roshan is going to go down.
Indeed it is. It doesn't look as much that C9 can do against this one. With EE down, they're just going to look to try and make the best of a worse situation. They're going to look to take the tier 2 here from the top lane. There's actually a bit of a rotation from Chuan and Faith heading up there. And I'll tell you what, the IG, they're not taking this Roshan that fast. I mean, he's only down to half health now. We are going to see, Misery keeping in.
Yeah. He has Boots of Travel to come here. My god, this is dangerous.
Oh, can C9 do this? The old Chuan with the solo echo slam onto Varta. But Chuan's going to get hexed up now. Big Daddy Noto coming in. The Sonic Wave onto 3. It's a perfect Sonic Wave. Varta's out of mana, though. He might go down. He's going to have to blink. No, he goes down there. They will find the pickoff, even though it was a lovely Sonic Wave. BKB's been popped by Ferrari. EE contemplating whether he can continue in this fight. There's going to be a hook shot onto Big Daddy. They will be able to find the Night Stalker. He's trying to turn around with the Void Damage burning. He's going to try and fight up against EE because EE's bringing them low. Faith, is he going to get out? Oh, there's your snowball. Balls onto everybody. Two people down. Lua trying to get himself out on the sidelines. Burning heading back up the fight. EE with the Diffusal Blade now. Going onto Burning with the Hex as well from Misery. There's going to be a nice Fisher holding back the aggression, but now the second last flies through. Faith coming through with the Illuminate. EE's got to dodge that one out. And now Blink 4 from Misery with a cheeky stun in the right click. Getting himself a double kill as he picks off the Ember Spirit at the back of that fight. And again, C9, they did lose a bit, but I've got to be honest, Misery with that final play there, bringing down the Ember Spirit, kind of makes it all worth it.
Yeah, that was a very important kill for them to get. Otherwise, I think it would be them losing two heroes and just one on the Shadow Fiend. But they did bought back on someone, I remember. I remember the buyback. I think it was Keeper. Yeah, Keeper bought
back. Yeah, Keeper bought back in that fight, didn't he? Yeah, it was indeed just the Keeper. Yeah. So, I mean, still, Roshan remains. The question is, who goes back there first, Winter?
IG is going to be... They need to take up their lanes first before they try and go back to the Roshan. Oshaker is desperately close to his Pink Dagger. Doesn't want to die anymore.
He certainly doesn't, though. And, Farta. He's got himself an Invis Ring. EE leading the aggression straight onto Ferrari, bringing him low in terms of mana and health. There's going to be a TP in for Burning, ready for this one. Farta's going in with the Invis, but he doesn't have that Sonic Wave here for 25 seconds. So maybe C9. Do they just go into the pit? Roshan, he's healing up a little bit slowly but surely. He's singing a half health at the moment. But these fights are proving very, very difficult for IG to take head on at this point.
Yeah, and C9 is just not in a hurry to take Rosh. They just need to make sure the lanes are pushed out and they can just continue farming on the PR. And PR is going to move towards top lane now, continue to speed push. And Lion is going to probably hide in the trees to wait for someone. They're probably going to just push the lane at top, and Lion's going to maybe camp nearby until someone comes to take care of the lanes and just kill the guy who comes.
Bottom lane, bo7 just throwing out the ice shards in. Needs to be a little bit careful. He is all alone. Big Daddy finding what he can here from the jungle. And I mean, the farm for the side of IG, Ferrari, still looking pretty healthy. I mean, he's on 10k gold at the moment. He's got that BKB on top of the mech and 1.1k as well. But EE, yeah, he's going to have a little bit more than that, and certainly if he's able to take down this tier 2 as well as IG.
Yeah.
It kind of seems like they don't really know what to do now at this point. I mean, what is IG's best bet at this point of the game?
They know they need to get the Aegis as soon as possible, but whoever who comes top now is going to die. Lion is just still nearby here waiting for someone to come and take care of the lanes.
There we go, E just holding the fort, ready to go with the spam onto Ferrari, forcing him back up to the high ground. The entirety of IG coming in, they were looking for a potential hook shot from the side there onto EE. But at the same time, the Sonic C9, they got Fata here in the jungle. He's got that Sonic Wave.
There's the blink on the Earthshaker here.
This is big, but the Hex onto Luo straight away, and the blink away from Fata means they're not going to be able to find anything. Indeed, though, the fact that Chuan is still smoked up, C9, they're still not totally aware that the blink dagger is available. And IG desperately looking for some kind of action, but the side of C9, they can smell it, and they head exactly in the opposite direction that IG are, and it looks like IG aren't going to find anything with this movement.
They probably should have used the echo stem on the corp just to secure at least one kill, but at the end of the game, they got nothing from the smoke, and PL is again happily pushing out the lanes, and I think he completed his mentor already. Yeah, he's going to be able to complete the mentor fairly soon and finds an illusion rune on top of that.
Yeah, we talked about the fact that he had a good game 1 and a bad game 2, and this certainly looks like it's rolling back round to the good game for himself. 3 kills, 6 assists, he's only died the once this match, and he's sitting at the top of the net worth board, 12k. And in the fights we've seen him take, he's been able to offer a hell of a lot, especially with just the fact that his item progression at this point in the game is incredibly healthy. Kiasha, Diffusal Blade, and the Booster Trowel. He's hitting hard and he's hitting fast, and it's just a little bit too much for IG to withstand in these engagements.
Yeah, I think the second reason why the PR is so effective right now is it's because the counter towards him, IG pick up the Ember, he's doing very, very badly in this game. So he has no battle fury, still no item progression yet. He still needs one more piece before he can complete his first battle fury.
Indeed. Well, how we're seeing the items coming out from everyone else. BDN, he's working towards his Aghanim Scepter. He's halfway there. He's got the point boost and the stuff and promote wizardry, and 26 minutes in, 20-12, the graphs as well, what do they show? Yeah, it's quite a big sizable lead now for C9, over 10,000 in terms of XP and over 10k in terms of gold. I mean, IG, they're smoking up again,
this
but
has to work. This has
it
to
has
work.
To, yeah.
Man, they're gonna fall very far behind if this doesn't work. Ideally, they kill the PL here. If they can find him fast enough before he moves towards the left side, and he's probably gonna go towards the top lane after that. Then they can't really catch him.
Well, there we go. Luo's moving in the right direction here. EE could get caught out very well, but he's got backup. Oh, the hookshot's not actually going to catch the real PL. He's going to be able to back up, and maybe the side of C9 can go into this one. Ice Shards and Lars onto Luo. Big fall from Misery with the Hex as well. Chuan trying to find what he can. He's used the Echo Stab already, but he just hasn't done enough. IG, they might need to think about getting themselves out of this. Sonic Wave flies through. It actually misses everyone. That was not the Sonic Wave that Fado was looking for. Now he blinks forward. He might be throwing away his life. There's 4 heroes here. He's still alive for the time being, but it's not going to be enough. They do lose Fate on the Quap, who had a bit of a misplay after misplay in that fight. They did manage to bring down the Shadow Fiend, so it's a 1-for-1. TP out from Luo. Chuan's trying to get himself out as well. Will find the blink. Looks like he will be able to escape. And a bit of a mess there from, well, both sides. I guess IG, they found the kill on Safada, but that was only because he messed up. And they did lose Ferrari on the Shadow Fiend.
And the Impel didn't land as well, that's why Clockwork managed to TP out. But at the start of the fight, I think it was an illusion that cancelled the blink. Earthshaker didn't blink before he Echo Slam, that's why. I think it was an illusion, I'm not very sure. Or he just missed his Echo Slam. I didn't pay attention fully to what the Shaker was doing, but I saw the Echo Slam went off behind the fight.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Must have been, yeah, something messed up with his blink, but... Yeah, a bit of a mess there from both sides, but I mean, they both don't lose too much, just to kill each on either of the respective mids, and the graph actually kind of showing that as well. It was like, yeah, that was an even one. It just kind of flat lines around that fight, as they're just two big cores dying on either side there.
Yeah, it was really, really messy, but at the end of the day, it was fairly an even trade. I would say it favors C9 more, because they have much stronger late game going into the draft and the hero picks. And Ember is going to be finishing his first battle for this game. His first item. Took him 28 minutes, but he didn't have a good game.
It was, indeed, not the best of Battle Fury timings, but as always, against a lineup with illusion-based heroes like the PL, it's always going to be kind of nice in these fights. He's going to be able to get a fair bit of damage out. That is, of course, if Misery's not there with the instant blink in, looking to lock down and control the Ember at the start of each and every one of these fights. And I think, as you were saying, the fact that it was even, because, IG, they need to find some positive action, and to be fair, just looking over what the last kind of, the last half of this game, they've just not found anything of the sorts, and Cloud9 just coming out on top every time.
They are going to be very nervous now, because the PL is getting too strong, and their Ember is not strong enough to deal with the PL, so they are going to hit a timing where they can't deal with the PL, and the PL can finish the game. Maybe as soon as he gets one more item, maybe a heart. I think if he gets a heart, then it's going to be difficult to clear out his illusions with the Ember being so far behind in item progression.
And there we go down the bottom lane. Ferrari getting the push on. He's got the backup in the sidelines of the rest of his team, if they want to try and pressure this tier 2, but with C9 all up, they're a little bit timid, a little bit scared. Fata just trying to get a bit of split push action here on the top lane, getting the creep momentum going his way. But, I mean, IG, still, Roshan, still sitting there, if a team wants to go for it, but I think IG, maybe a little bit too scared to attempt it. Yeah, and C9 don't need to, really.
And top lane, they're going to go try and hex and try to start the fight. Yeah, no, Ashaker still in position to make sure that the Ember is safe here. But like you talk about Roshan, no one wants to go now. IG doesn't find a suitable timing to go for, because the lanes are constantly being pushed out by just one PR constantly boosts of traveling between top and bottom, making sure two lanes are pushed out. And it's very difficult for IG to keep the lanes pushed out as fast as the PR. The PR is just pushing a lot faster.
Oh, he's going to try for it here. Oh, they're going to try and give it a go, yeah. I mean, the DD, it's the Roche special. But look at this at the same time. C9, they're smoked up. Well, everyone apart from Fata, they've got all the ults online. This is a very risky move, and indeed, IG, they realize they don't want to be here. They do back up and keep themselves safe here. And the VG sigil there, scouting them out.
Fata has a completed BKB, so C9 are looking very strong to take a fight right now, with the Queen of Pain having the new shiny BKB. So she's not going to be so worried about what happened the last time when she blinked up and she got killed by disables and stuns. So this time around with the BKB, she's going to be blinking up. She can blink very aggressive and not worry about anything apart from maybe a hook shot, because that's the only thing that goes through BKB right now.
Indeed, and still EE continuing the farm game, coming up to 16k. He's now 3,000 or so above the Shadow Fiend's farm, and with 2.7k going in the bank. Oh, he needs to be careful, Lua. Yeah, maybe thinking of Hookshot and indeed top lane. The fight also continues well. Fata and Bernie. Fata will simply blink away, and EE, it's got to be careful here. Well, it's going to be fine. Looks like IG aren't going to continue to go into their own jungle, so EE's going to be safe.
Night Stalker has just come online.
Oh boy. Axe indeed, on its way out in the courier. Big Daddy Nota. So now the game just gets just a little bit harder for IG to fight into the side of C9 at night time. Just a little bit.
Being really generous.
But it's going to be a hook shot onto Bone 7 here. He's going to have the snowball. They're going to need some health, C9, if they want to try and turn this fight. He's turned up with the Spirit Lance here onto Luo. But Luo's going to be fine for the time being with the help of the Glimmer Cape. BKB's popped by Ferrari. He's looking for the Requiem of Soldier. Will come out. It's not going to catch anyone. I caught EE by the looks of it. Yeah, the debuff. Right click damage is going to be removed from EE. The Glimmer Cape and the Doppelganger allowing EE to just keep himself alive. Maybe he wants to turn this one back around. The 3 heroes on the side of IG in the midst of it all. On the sidelines, the finger from Misery was enough to finish off the Ember Spray. So it's 2 heroes first down at the moment on IG. Ferrari is out of mana. Oh, there's a nice echo slam onto two. And now with the punches from Ferrari, is it quite enough? Big Daddy heads himself away with the charges as well, popping them, keeping himself up. Now your snowball comes in. Ferrari goes down. Lua's out of mana. Boston will try and chase that one down. He's looking for the water sponge. At the same time, Chuan, he's feeling the damage of EE and Misery going to work on him. Chuan will fall. It's only Lua remaining. Big Daddy there with a void slow from the high ground. Boston finishing off with the ice shards. There's going to be a full team wipe against IG. And C9 once again showing IG that they really can't take a fight against this lineup.
Man, that buyback into that Glimmer play saving the carry, that was just all Bone 7 that fight. He came up with a very important buyback and managed to save Mr. Jackie Ma from dying, and he managed to keep dealing damage during the fights, and Queen of Pain was able to reach towards the PL's position because of the Glimmer Cape and help him out. So that was a very crucial Glimmer Cape play from Bone 7 there.
And I mean, even with the team wipe, the side of Cloud9 not feeling that they've got the tools to take down Roshan, leaving it open. And I mean, yeah, if we have a look at the graphs after that one, that's looking painful. It's reaching almost the point of no return here. IG, they need something big to happen. We've seen them attempt a few smokes this game, and with that movement as well, very aggressively into the range jungle. I mean, what is the best plan now for IG? Do they need to look for these engagements, or can they hang back and try and wait for Cloud9 to come to them?
Top lane. Burning. No, not again.
He's okay. Only
Lion
just
was a little too far. Lion was a little too far. I mean, Quop went a fraction too early. Yeah. Because there were like still three creeps, so the Ember would most likely kill all the creeps before going out. But they're talking about what IG can do right now and what could they hope for. They need to win a team fight. Because Ember, there's no way Ember can catch up with the net worth of the PL without something drastic happening, like a big echo slam or a team wipe. Otherwise, if you're talking about pure farm, just by farming, yeah, Ember is not going to catch up. They need to make something drastic happen, like a Roshan taking a fight after you just acquire Aegis, or a great initiation from Earthshaker or Hookshot, something along the lines of that. Otherwise, the Ember is just going to be always behind the PR throughout the game.
I mean, it certainly gets the point out. EE, he's got the Reaver. Curry is on its way out to, he just needs to find that final bit of gold there for the Vip boost, and with your heart on the PL as well, it's getting to the point where it's going to be very hard to kill EE. They're going to try and give him a bit of a slider fist there, but he's going to be able to doppelganger away. As Cloud9 maybe looking to take a tier 2 or, and even take a few lives as well if the side of IG want to fight into it. Far to now, 3k gold on this Quop. What does he go for next, Winter?
Maybe an armor item, like maybe a Shiva's or Refresher. I think those are two really good items for him this game. Obviously, the Shiva's would be good to deal with the Shadow Fiend, but the Refresher would also provide a lot of team fight potential, and double BKBs is really good against IG's lineup.
Yes, indeed, and looking at the rest of the team, so let's have a look how Bone7's doing. So indeed, we saw the Glimmer Cape coming into big play there in that last final fight, and with the Blink Dagger finish up as well. IG, how's their lineup looking? They've got that beat Blink Dagger indeed on Chuan. Ember has got the crit now with the cleave. Shadow Fiend looking towards a butterfly now on top of the S and Y. Kotl, he is working for that Aghanim's. He's fairly close, 900 gold away, but the fact that he's doing that against a lineup with this Nightstalker is, I mean, I guess you have the bonus of being in that kind of god form for the majority of the time, but the fact you don't get that vision bonus, it's certainly going to hurt for the side of IG.
And you were talking about Bone7's item build. I think this is the first game we see Tusk not building a mech in this tournament. Mostly it's a mech into the Greaves, because you're going to get Arcane Boots, but his item build definitely paid off in the last fight, for sure. Something new, but it definitely paid off.
Now, IG again, they're kind of stuck in this position, wondering what the best thing is to do here, just standing strong here by this final, well, the penultimate tier 2s that they've got here on the mid and the bottom lane. And C9 still feeling very comfortable. Let's check the graphs again. Yeah, it's ticked in, so we're about a 20k XP lead and a 15k gold lead here for the side of C9. Big Daddy looking for a potential wraparound here.
This is what he does every time before his team pushes. He's going to run behind and give the team vision of the crucial jump heroes on the opposing team. And in this game, the most important target he needs to see with his vision is the Earthshaker. He needs to constantly give his team the info about the whereabouts of the Earthshaker, because the only way I think IG can win a fight is by the Earthshaker doing really well initiation with the Echo Stand.
Oh, Faith. He may have come out a little bit too far with the void, and the illusion's doing so much damage to Faith. It will be Glimmer Cave Turb, which will buy him some time. Sentry's been popped down. That's going to be the illusion's going to continue to go to work. Farter, he fires the Sonic Wave. They brought down Ferrari here on the Shadow Beam. Burning's coming in. He will be able to Remnant out just before he loses the mana. But now with the Hex, they're going to lose Burning as well. This is terrible for IG. They've lost three heroes. They do have a buyback available on Burning, but there's no buyback on Ferrari. There's going to be no buyback on the Kotal. There is a buyback available for Lua. Double kill for EE, as it's going to be a full team wipe again against the side of IG. And at this point, I mean, even though they can buy back, I just don't know what they can do against the side of Cloud9, Winter.
Buyback feels like it's just delaying the inevitable for them.
It certainly does at this point. Fortification will come out, but Cloud9, they're on the top lane tier 3s. And is that, yeah? There we go. Farters ready for round 2 here. And yeah, tier 2 in the mid lane, getting low as well. And look at EE. He's...
You know you've won when you're doing this, you know.
Look at him go.
Man, you thought you only see this in pubs.
Classy Jackie, man. Wow. He won't find the kill, though. It'll just be a bit of a nuisance there for the Kotal. And that is indeed going to be the top set of racks down. So IG, they do have the full lineup here. Maybe they can look for the wombo combo here, but they're going to need a real wombo combo if they want to turn this one around at this point. Oh, man.
Ashaka's the hero. Is he going to be the hero? He's smoked up. Is he going to be the hero?
Oh, shot. It's going to catch out E. There's going to be the Cogs as well. Chuan's still looking for the perfect angle, Sam. Cogs is going to force E back now. He is out of mana. And looks like that's all it's going to be. Just forcing Cloud9 away from the base. And that's going to get the job done. Looks like Cloud9 don't want to stick around for round 2 there in the mid lane straight away.
I think they just need to wait for the Sonic Wave to come up cooldown and make sure they have two waves for the next fight, and I mean, it's just going to be an easy fight from there on.
I mean, I think at this point, do we look towards the Rapier Ember Spirit?
Can you even get there?
I think that's the biggest question, isn't it? Yeah. Only 2k gold in the bank at the moment. They're going to need something a bit more spectacular to be able to get that kind of funding. And yeah, it's reaching 30,000 XP, and it's the same story in terms of net worth. I mean, this is the point where very few games are turned around. But against Cloud9, you never know what Cloud9 are going to do. They still might mess it up, you know. If there was ever a team that was going to screw up at this point, Cloud9, they might be that team. But we'll see. They're looking very comfortable at the moment, and IG, they're going to need nothing less than a miracle if they want to take a fight against these heroes who are incredibly stacked. I mean, EE at the moment on top of the heart, he's got an Eagle Song, and he's very close to finishing off that. Well, he's about 2,000 away from the Butterfly. It looks like they want to take Roshan here as well, Cloud9. It's just going to make it just that little bit harder for IG to even have a hope of taking Cloud9 down in a team fight at this point, 40 minutes into the game.
I mean, it's so easy for them to win a fight now. As long as they catch the Earthshaker, I think IG has no chance of winning a team fight. If they're able to spot the Earthshaker's position and just focus him down first right away, I think IG does the fight immediately. That's all they need to do. All their eggs is on Chuan's basket.
Yeah, there we go. He's sticking around. IG. Are they going to be able to contest this at all? It doesn't look like they're in the mindset to do so. Hanging back, Big Danny No-Tail is going to be there scouting out any kind of movement as well. He's taking a bit of time to do this one. Right, it's actually going to back up now out of the pit. Doesn't look like he wants to finish this one off. Lots of pings coming out here. IG, they've got the Luo there with the hook shot. Maybe looking to initiate. Baby, oh, Big Danny No-Tail. Oh, Father's picking in here. He's looking for the Sonic Wave. Onto Fable. Oh, with the finger as well. There's refreshing out. Big Ford, he's looking for some more action. Tron will get off the Echo Snap, but it doesn't matter. He goes down as well. On the side of the lines, there's going to be Luo getting caught out here by Misery and Big Danny No-Tail. He's out of mana. There's going to be Bone 7 snowballing in, cancelling the TP. Luo goes down as well. Three heroes dropping on the side of IG. None of them with buyback available. Tier 2 will go down in the bottom lane. And it looks like Cloud9 will say, screw Roshan. We want to take another set of racks. And with that, maybe even the game as well. Oh, Hex onto Burning. Lance flying through as well. Burning is going to go down. War is supposed to finish it off and seal the deal. Ferrari will pop the BKB. He gets the Requiem of Souls out. Sonic Wave, I don't know what he was trying to Sonic Wave there, but it wasn't Ferrari apparently. And Ferrari will be able to walk himself back to base. But still, he's the only one remaining on the side of IG. He's starting to work away onto the tower. And it looks like this time, Cloud9 is certainly ensuring that they don't mess this game up. And it looks like they're in a very good position to take this game and move forward to the semi-finals, Winter.
was a really great performance from the whole team in general, but like I mentioned before during the draft, IG had a lineup that doesn't allow them to make many mistakes, and this game, the first few crucial engagements in, especially all the early fights, like Ember kept on dying and dying. That was the point where it set IG so far back, with Ember losing his life every fight.
There we go. Mid-Rax, they're going down. IG, they're still short on Ember Spirit for 15 seconds. He's got buyback, but at this point, there's not a lot that's going to be able to offer the side as Mega Creeps are out. Tron makes the call. GG, well played. Cloud9, they win the series 2-1 against IG, and they will be moving forward to play against Secret tomorrow in the semi-finals here at the Mars Dota TV League. Well, Winter, what a series, and Cloud9, they pull it out of the bag at the end of the day.
Yeah, that's going to be a very interesting series. For me, the highlight for this game alone is the buyback from the Tusk to the Glimmer Cape that saved